Member Delta North.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. On December 13th, people across the world will pay tribute to the lives of more than 200,000 Chinese victims in the city of Nanjing. In late 1937, during the Second Sino-Japanese War, hundreds of thousands of people, including both soldiers and civilians, were killed. The horrific events are known as the Nanjing Massacre, and many reports documented 20 to 80,000 women were sexually assaulted. As Canadians, we are well informed by many historic and current events happening around the world where women and children are often the first casualties of war and armed conflicts. Here is a story of a survivor. My name is Chen Jia Shu. When the armies invaded Nanjing in 1937, I was only 19 years old. I was taken by some nearby soldiers and brought to a pond adjacent to Shanghai Road. Soldiers hustled several lines of what 200 Chinese troops toward the edge of the pond. I was terribly frightened. Thus, the instant the soldiers opened fire on us all, I immediately fell towards the ground, faking my death. Struck by flying bullets, my Chinese comrades all piled on top of my body. Right up until it got dark and the soldiers had all left, I lay underneath the dead bodies, not daring to move. I waited till dark when the soldiers left. It was thus how I became a fortunate survivor of the Nanjing Massacre. Honorable Speaker, Canadian-Japanese writer Joe Kagawa wrote in the Toronto Star that large-scale acts of violence in history need to be widely known and studied so they're not repeated. Whereas the Holocaust in Europe is taught and remembered, the same cannot be said for wide-scale atrocities in Asia's history. This December 13th will be the 80th anniversary of the horrific events. Commemorative events will be held across the country and the world, and I urge members of this House to attend events in their communities. Thank you, Honorable Speaker.
Thank you, Member.